name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen. Lord, have mercy. Winfrith was born in Crediton and found his way via Exeter and the south coast of England to working in Frisia as a missionary. He became known as Boniface, the doer of good, and at different times he fell out with the church authorities on what he should and should not be doing. He was called to Rome, where he was commissioned to carry out mission work in Hesse, around the area of Frankfurt, and also in Bavaria. But off he went back to Frisia, and after a short period of time in his later years as Archbishop of Mainz, off he went again, when he could get out of it, back to Frisia. He was a nuisance to the authorities, and clearly he was a nuisance to those pagan rulers in that area of Frisia, because in 754 he was killed for preaching faith. So Boniface was a nuisance to the authorities, to the people around him. He was determined, he was set upon the mission to the people of Frisia, and for that he gave his life, and for that he is now known as the Apostle of Germany. Bringing faith to people is, as Jesus often teaches, a matter of persistence and perseverance. It is a matter of being prepared to be a nuisance when you know you are doing the right thing. And of course, of making peace when you think you may be doing the wrong thing. So let us pray today for ourselves and for the church which we serve, the Christ who is our best friend, our lover, and who is alive within us. Let us pray that we will be prepared to be nuisances on his behalf, and however people receive us, that we will be patient and persistent in living and preaching our faith. We have failed in that, and for all our sins, let us ask God's forgiveness. Brothers and sisters in Christ, as we gather at the Lord's table, we must recall the promises and warnings given to us in the Scriptures. Let us therefore examine ourselves and repent of our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heartfelt repentance and true faith turn to him. Have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, who called your servant Boniface to preach the gospel among the German people and to build up your church in holiness, grant that we may preserve in our hearts that faith which he taught with his words and sealed with his blood, and profess it in lives dedicated to your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. You have observed my teaching, my conduct, my aim in life, my faith, my patience, my love, my steadfastness, my persecutions, and my suffering, the things that happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra. What persecutions I endured! Yet the Lord rescued me from all of them. Indeed, all who want to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. But wicked people and impostors will go from bad to worse, deceiving others and being deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have known the sacred writings that are able to instruct you for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Great peace have they who love your law. Great peace have they who love your law. Princes have persecuted me without a cause, but my heart stands in awe of your word. I am as glad of your word as one who finds great spoils. Great peace have they who love your law. Great peace have they who love your law. Nothing shall make them stumble. Lord, I have looked for your salvation, and I have fulfilled your commandments. Great peace have they who love your law. My soul has kept your testimonies, and greatly have I loved them. I have kept your commandments and testimonies, for all my ways are before you. Great peace have they who love your law. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. While Jesus was teaching in the temple, he said, How can the scribes say that the Messiah is the son of David? David himself, by the Holy Spirit, declared, The Lord said to my Lord, Sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet. David himself calls him Lord, so how can he be his son? And the large crowd was listening to him with delight. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. To pray today for the parish of St. Michael and All Angels Alvaster, and in the Anglican Communion cycle of prayer for the dioceses of the New Guinea Islands in Papua New Guinea and of Algoma in the Anglican Church of Canada. On this feast of St. Boniface, we pray for the people of Germany, particularly for the Archdiocese of Mainz, for the people of Frisia, for those who preach the gospel in those places today, for those who live the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray for a new impulse and impact of missionary work here and elsewhere. We thank God for the example of people like St. Boniface, who were prepared to give their all in order to follow God's calling. As we pray, we remember those who suffer from coronavirus, and especially those who are in places where medical facilities and education are scarce. We pray too for those who are angry, for those who riot and protest, for those who are called to keep the peace, for those who are affected by injustice of any kind. May we find peaceful ways to right wrong and to correct the many injustices of this world. We pray for the sick and remember by name Sarah Fields, John Murrity, Paul Taylor, Jane Stratton, Kenneth Hughes, Robin Glasson, Jean Knox, Laura, Ian McKenzie, David Staves, Jane Jackson, Jean Maiden, Sue Hastings, Patricia Mitchell, Jane Hostin, Charlize Kane, John Robinson, Sheila Laverick, Carol Kingham, Joan Lydgate, Teddy, June Franklin, John Herring and Michael Catton. And as we remember those who have gone before us in faith, we pray for those who have died of coronavirus in this community and elsewhere. We pray for George Henry Sedgwick, whose ears mind occurs today, and among the recently departed, we pray for Jim Vaughan. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Strengthen Libby, our Bishop, and all your Church in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless and guide Elizabeth, our Queen. Give wisdom to all in authority and direct this and every nation in the ways of justice and of peace, that we may honour one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give grace to us, our families and friends, and to all our neighbours, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer, in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Boniface, and of all your saints, we commend ourselves and the whole creation to your unfailing love as we say, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. God is love, And those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. The peace of the God of love be always with you. As the grain once scattered in the fields, and the grapes once dispersed on the hillside, are now reunited on this table in bread and wine, so, Lord, may your whole church soon be gathered together from the corners of the earth into your kingdom. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise for ever. From the beginning you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You give us breath and speech, that with angels and archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. The night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Christ is the bread of life. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory. Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity, guard her faith, and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Boniface, and all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created us, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours for ever and ever. Amen. United by God's Spirit, let us pray to the Father in the words Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Lord, we pray that your grace may always precede and follow us, and make us continually to be given to all good works, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And the blessing and the love of the Lord the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth in peace. In the name of Christ.